Whether you sell t-shirts to raise money for your YouTube channel or digital products like your latest feature film, within Wix we can set up an online shop in just minutes with only a few clicks. Hey everyone, Jordi here for Cinecom.net and welcome to the creative channel for filmmakers. And what if we could sell our creativity in an online shop? Merchandise, ebooks, tickets for your feature film, you name it. In a previous video, we've seen how to create your own website using Wix, and in this tutorial, we're going to build an online shop in that website.
And we're back in the dashboard of our website, where we can see all the options. Now, in order to create that online shop, you do have to upgrade your account to an e-commerce plan. And you can see that right here in my options here, plan e-commerce. Now that does cost a little money, but you know, the whole purpose of having an online shop is so that you can make money. So why not spend a little bit to have a good platform where you can start selling your stuff. But first, let's see how we can actually create that online store. So what I'm gonna do is go back to edit website, which will bring me to the Wix editor. And right here, we are back at the website that we have created in the previous video. And if you haven't seen that one yet, then just click on the card somewhere up here in the corner right, and that will bring you to that video. Now, like with anything else, to add a new element to your website, we just head over to the menu here on the left, click on Add, and head over to Store down below here, and then just click Add to Site. And that will create a bunch of new elements. Like also here in the top, you can see that Shop has been added to your menu. And if you like, so you can change that, of course, by going into your pages settings and just rename that by double clicking on it. For example, the cinema store. Done. Because we are going to sell film tickets or like a printing service, anything like that, that has something to do with our business, of course. Now, next to that, you will also see this little cart icon right here. And this is something that you can drag around again. So make sure to give that a proper place. And no, I don't want tips because you guys have me. So screw those tips. I'm going to drag that shopping cart here next to my menu, something like that. And if you click on that, you can also change that like with anything with Wix. We've seen that in a previous video. If you go to settings, we can change how that cart has to look. So perhaps you like this one more, change that color. I'm gonna make that grayish, change the size a little bit. You know the drill, right? So then right here where it says this page has no products to show at the moment, this is where your shop goes. Now you guys will probably see some demo products right here, but what I've done is deleted them already. And while I was creating this tutorial, something went wrong, so I had to re-record them. And for some reason, I can't get those default products back. I had to create an entire new website. So just know that that could be a little bit different. But to go to your products, just hit here on the top left, manage products. And that will bring you to the back end or the settings of your actual shop. And there are a couple of things that we have to go through here on the left, but let's start with those products. If you see those demo products right here, then just delete them all, and then we can start with our own products. Click on new products and give that a name. For example, we have shot a new feature film and we'd like to invite family and friends, but you know, renting that place to showcase the film and having some people doing the drinks and stuff, you know, that'll cost money. So let's charge a little bit and sell a ticket. So I'm going to call this feature film. Then as an image, we're going to upload the movie poster right here. This here is just the media library like we've seen. You can upload new images, but I've already done that. This right here is my movie poster. So I'm just going to select that and say apply. And if you like so, you can also add multiple images in here. So for example, you can also add some behind the scenes. These two right here are from that film, some behind the scenes pictures. So I'm just gonna say apply as well. So now we have this small gallery. Then scroll down and here you can give that a price for the tickets. You can give that a little description and so on. Now what we are going to do though is we're going to work with two different kinds of tickets. You know, we've got the premium seats, which are more at front, and then we've got the standing seats. You know, the place that we've rented isn't that big, so not everyone can sit, and I do expect a lot of viewers, so that's why we're going to work with two kinds of tickets. Now, what I do suggest here is to set a base price, so that means the lowest ticket price, set that right in here. For example, the standing ticket is going to be 10 euros, and then add a description for just the entire product, for example, a short summary of what your film is about, and looking at this photo right here, it's definitely a war film. So war is going on, But everyone wants peace. A romantic film by Jordy. And if you like, you can style that a bit more, add links to it, put some stuff here in bold, like that. Then scroll a bit more down. Of course, the tickets are in stock. You can change that right here. But also, you can track the inventory. So if you enable that, we can say, well, we only have 50 tickets. And ones that they are sold, you know, they're gone. And the next time you play that film, it's going to be a lot more expensive. You can do a bunch more, like setting a custom text in here. But right here, it's really getting interesting. The product options. Click on that. This allows you to set multiple different things of that same product. For example, like a t-shirt, which has different sizes. Right now, we're going to see two tickets. We've got the premium seats and we've got the standing seats. So this is just a ticket option. And as a list, which is exactly what we want, you can also set a color. But for your list, we're going to set the premium seats, comma, and then say the standing places, comma. And that will create two kinds of choices. And once you've done that, you can dive into the customized settings per variation, enable that. And right here, you can see these two options. And you can also add an additional price for that. So it also says right here a surcharge. So for your standing places, I'm just going to leave that on zero. You know, the price is just going to be 10 euros, so it doesn't have to add anything more to the price that we set here in the beginning. But for the premium seats, you know, that is going to cost a lot more. So I'm just going to add 10 extra euros to that. And that's it. The product is all done. If we're going to hit on save now here on top, it will save that product here in my gallery. Now I can just close that, and on my website, you will see that product appearing. Now, for some reason, it's out of stock, and that's probably because I've set something wrong. So I'm just going to head back to manage page and see what I've done here. And of course, every ticket has its own inventory. We don't have 50 tickets. No, we only have 10 premium seats, and the other 40 are the standing places. So there you know, these are real premium seats. And now we set actual inventories for these tickets. And if we close that again, we won't see that out of stock anymore. So there we have it, the very first product. Let's add another one. We're going to head back to manage products. And let's say if you are a photographer and you would like to sell some prints, you can also do that. So I'm going to head over to new product again, give that a name, let's say photo print. Add some images if you like so. And I've got one right here, apply. And the price is going to be, you know, 10 euros again. That's the setup cost. And you know what? It's on sale because it's holidays and such. So let's just put 10% off. There we go. Give that a little description. The best photo print you'll ever see. And we don't need to track the inventory because once the ink is out, you know, we just buy a new one. But we do have some more options for the products. You know, this is the print size. And for example, we've got an A5 print, we've got an A4 print, and finally the big one, an A1 print. Go into the settings of that, and you can add a surcharge to that. For example, the A5 is going to be 20 euros, the A4 is going to be like 30, and if you want the A1, the big one, you're going to pay 50 bucks, euros actually, extra. Everything is in stock. If you want to add some weight to it, you can also do that. You can use this, for example, for the shipping cost, where you can say, this is something for later in this video, where you can say everything above 1 kilo is that shipping cost, everything above 3 kilos has that shipping cost, and so on. But you know, we're living in modern times, we do free shipping. So hit that save button, and now we've got two products in the store. So let's close that right there, photo print, and it's even on sale. Now, like we are used to with Wix, we can again style the look of your store. We can head over to the settings right here. Instead of going to manage products, we can also go to settings. And that will bring up a new pop-up box where we can actually style this whole thing. So for the product style, I'm just going to click here on something else. Also change the hover style where the product kind of zooms in instead of showing an alternate image. As for the display, I don't like that line between that. So we can just disable that divider like so. And these settings continues. Also, we got three other tabs here, styles and colors here as well. So you can really customize how it has to look. But there's one last option here in the Wix store, and that are the store pages. You know, we don't only have this store page, but we also have product pages. We've got the checkout page, we've got the cart page, and so on. If you click on that, you just first say get started, and that will show you those different pages. So currently we are at the cinema store, but if we click on product page, we will see an example of the photo print, for example. And again, in here, we can start changing the way it has to look. So we can click on these elements here and go into the settings and change the stuff. For example, I don't like that purple color. So head over to the display settings and I should find right here the button and the background of that is purple. And I'm going to change that to green because, you know, everyone is attracted to green. Now people are for sure going to click on that button and buy my photo prints. But of course, we've got a bunch more options. Just go through them. They are all pretty straightforward. But going back to those pages here, store pages, we also have the cart. So this is where people collect their stuff and then they are going to go to the checkout. And finally, we've got a thank you page. Once that people have paid for their products, then you can say thank you so much. You know, if we go into the settings here for buying my stuff, thanks for shopping. We're going to say thank you for being so awesome. Now that is something you want to hear as a buyer. All right, let's go back to my store settings here on the left. The store pages, go back to the cinema store, because what we want to do here is go into the manage products. We've got a bunch more settings on the left, one of which are the orders. And here you will see a list of all the orders once that someone made a payment so that you know, it's ordered, it's paid and stuff, and you can start doing your shipping. Or perhaps put an update on Facebook like, hey, you've already sold like 40 tickets. There are only 10 left. Purchase it now or pay double the price the second time I will showcase my feature film. There's also an option to promote your store where you can create an email campaign right here. And this really works well if you have like new products that you want to tell your audience about, or there's a certain sale going on during the holidays. You can tell people about your sale so that they know that's going on. Pretty good to have that also right in here so that you don't have to use other emailing software and such. Everything sits right inside Wix. But then we've got business setup, and this option is very important because without these options, you can't collect any money. So let's go quickly through these options as well. The business name, it's Jordy Inc. And I'm in the art and photography industry. I'm going to set up a logo. I've already uploaded that right here. My awesome Jordy logo. The payment info is something that we're going to set later. First, we're going to set some contact information. Also very important, if you are going to deal with people who are paying for your products, then make sure that you have some kind of a contact information. If something went wrong, they might not be satisfied or anything like that. Make sure that you help your customers. You want to have satisfied customers. Even though that something went wrong with the product, make sure that you always come up with a solution. Even if that is a refund or a coupon to your store, anything like that. So add your contact information here. But then let's go to the payments here on the left. And there are three kinds of payments, gateways actually, that we can set up. The first one is credit cards, then we've got PayPal, and finally the offline payment. Now when selling those film tickets to the family, you know, grandma and stuff is coming, and they don't have PayPal yet. They tried it, but they first wanted to get the hang of Twitter and then go further with PayPal and Candy Crush and stuff. So let's set up an offline payment. And an offline payment is really a custom way of how people can pay for your products. So you can put anything in here. For example, put the money on account 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. No, that's not what it says. It says 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 within 7 business days. There we go. So put some clear instructions right in here of what people have to do in order to make that payment. You can also say visit this address here between this hour and that hour to bring cash. That is completely up to you, but be aware that you have to do everything manually. If those people pay for your products, make sure that you also go into your order settings here on the left and that you check mark those orders as, you know, it's paid. If that's something that's not going to happen automatically if you're working with these offline payments. So I'm just going to say activate offline payments. There we go. It's added. You can always change that text afterwards. Now, the same thing goes for PayPal as well. I'm going to say connect to PayPal. But of course, be aware of the extra charges you'll get with PayPal. So yes, I already have a PayPal account. You know, it's PayPal at jordythefreelancer.wix.com. I don't know what my website was again. What's my website here? Cinecom.net. Wixsite.com. So that, okay, whatever. This is my PayPal address. I'm going to say activate account. So this is where the so-called PayPal money is going to come in. Then let's head over to shipping. Like I said before, we live in a modern world where shipping is free. It already knows that I'm from Belgium, and we like, so we can go in through the settings of my country. And yes, free shipping, of course. You can set some optional information here, how long that the shipping has to take. Like I said before, if you do would like to charge shipping, you can set that by weight of the product. So everything below a kilogram is so much, everything above that is so much, and so on. Or just set one flat rate or a rate by the price of the product. But again, we live in a modern world, so let's go for that free shipping. Unfortunately, we do have to add taxes. And in Europe, you know, it's different for every country here. So different tax rates within region. For Belgium, that's 21% tax. And our country, probably Europe, is the best at such things. I actually have to charge different tax rates depending on which country that the buyer is coming from. Luckily, Wix will calculate that or see that by itself, so I don't have to ask each client where they are coming from. But we do have to set that all. So you want to spend some time in here to set the tax rates for every country. For example, Germany, and it has 16 states, so apparently you can change that for every state in there. Or you can just say select all of them and have just one global tax rate, because I do believe that Germany has just one tax rate. And if I'm correct, it was 25%, so that's even a bit more. And that just keeps continuing, so welcome to our world, or welcome to Europe, let's put it that way. So just save that setting. We also set an international shipping method. For the rest of the world, we just have to calculate the Belgian tax rate, if I'm correct, or I should ask my accountant. He probably knows more about that. And finally, we've got these store settings to close everything. We can set different languages in here. We can also set the currency. So currently, everything was in euros, but of course, we can set that to US dollars if you like so in here. Again, the price format, kilogram, or would you like to work with pounds and feet and toes and ears, and so on. Do you have some terms and conditions, a privacy policy, a refund policy? Then make sure to check one of these boxes and type in whatever you like in here. For example, 30-day refund guaranteed. And this, my friends, is how we can set up that beautiful online store. Now, one last thing that I do like to show you guys, and that is if we go back to the homepage from the menu here, now, since that we've set up that store, we do like to showcase some kind of a featured product on the homepage, which is very important, and that's something that we can do very easily. If you go back to that ad menu here on the left and go to store, as you can see, it's activated right now. So we can use different kinds of elements from the store and just drag that anywhere to the website. For example, this awesome product widget, just gonna put that down below here in my website on the homepage like that, and I'm gonna move my gallery a bit below. There we go. And if we click on that, we can head over to settings and choose which kind of product that we would like to showcase in here. So we can connect that, for example, to the feature film. Again, change the different styles if you like so. And now it also sits on the homepage so that everyone who visits your site can see that you have a featured product. The awesome romantic film about the war where everyone just wants to have peace with each other. And we're done, so hit that save button and hit that publish button as well. And now the shop is online and we can start buying this awesome stuff. So right here, you've got the cinema store, that feature film. And you know what? I'm going to take premium seats. Let's just take like 10 tickets of that. Add to cart. 200 euros, few cart. And it should calculate the taxes in here as well. Once that I'm going to input from which country that I am. Let me just see that Belgium, oh, right here, Belgium. And there we go, 42 euros taxes. And now it's just way too much. I'm not going to pay 242 euros just for some film tickets.
I'm very curious to see how you've designed your website, so pop that link in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, stay creative.